Hello, good evening. My name is Aaron Victor, and I'm here to talk to you a little bit about myself and also a little bit about talent acquisition. So, just to begin, I have 8 years of talent acquisition in regards to employment branding, talent management, and campus programs. So, what I like to do in talent acquisition is basically finding the right employees for the organization. At the same time, helping people look into what are their talents and what are their skills like. So I'm here today, stuck in the middle of the traffic, stuck in jam. So I'm trying to tell you about how talents. A lot of people like us are stuck in traffic jam somehow. Most probably is there are a couple of things that first we don't plan our time plan, we don't do the proper routes that we need to take. You know, you have technology and you don't rely on technology. At the same time, you need to take control of that. And how do you do that? It's actually you need to plan, you need to prepare, then you need to execute. You also have to be ready for the unexpectability of things. That, things that could change. And talent is not just like a bus you would take or a car that you choose to take. Talent changes over time. You know, one time of your career, probably driving a motorcycle down and to work, and you probably at one point take a train, and then over the years as you grow in experience and with the level of work that you do, you probably start taking the cab, and then earn enough to buy a car. Evolve, change is imminent in everything that we do. So that being said, we need to understand what the world is changing. So is talent. Talent is always wide variety, ever evolving. There's no more one track. People are starting to be doctors, and then doctors are now becoming medical device engineers. So the world is changing, and people very scientific now, becoming more adept at doing business, and people who are non-technical are becoming technical with a lot of programming, and there's a lot of things there actually, so that being said, with all that, talent is not very easy. I mean, try only to attract, but to in regards to getting them to your organization. I mean, you could do all the fancy things, you could get them to apply online. The other equation to it is, once you attract talent, how do you engage them? And not only for your current requirements, but future requirements. So there's no easy answer to that. I mean, a lot of people who have found that in terms of technology, or if they have found that to done that, it's all great, but I doubt that's been achieved anyway. Now, everyone currently in the recruitment industry, or whether it is talent acquisition, is still stuck in this dilemma. So, I'm still on this journey, and I definitely have some ideas and some ways to look at it differently. Well, if anyone is interested to hear, as you can see, I'm bored with a lot of ideas going on. Wouldn't mind sharing it with an organization, passionate to take on people and develop talent, and at the same time, an organization that will make an impact in the world we are today. It's not just doing great products and great services, but how do we connect with a large number of people? And it's not about processes. I think it's also offering a better quality of life for its employees, customers, and doing great things. Well, that's a little bit about me. So definitely would like a chance to have a further conversation in regards to talent acquisition, HR, employee engagement, employer branding, and anything else that's related to Malaysia and across the world. And this is Aaron Victor signing off.